Chapter 15, Section 5 is on parametric surfaces. Our objectives are to understand the definition of a parametric surface and sketch the surface, find a set of parametric equations to represent a surface, find a normal vector and a tangent plane to a parametric surface, and find the area of a parametric surface. This is the definition of a parametric surface. We have x, y, and z are functions of u and v that are continuous. And the set of all the points that are given by this r in terms of u and v, it's a vector valued function using the parameters u and v, equals x of uvi plus y of uvj plus z of uvk. This is called the parametric surface. The equation x equals a function of u and v, y equals a function of u and v, and z equals a function of u and v. Those are called the parametric equations for the surface. Now recall when we looked at vector valued functions that represented a path, we had r in terms of a single parameter t in both the plane curve and a space curve. Again, these were both functions of a single parameter t. Those represented curves in the plane or the space. Now we're looking at this vector valued function in terms of two parameters. This is going to create a surface in space. Now if S is a parametric surface given by the vector valued function r, then S is traced out by its position vector r in terms of u and v as the point uv moves throughout the domain D. The great shaded gray circle here would represent the domain. Notice this should be a u and a v axis. This x here is actually labeled for the right side of the graph, but this is your horizontal axis is your u axis and vertical axis is your v axis. This is a two-dimensional domain here in terms of u and v, and that corresponds to every point in the domain corresponds to a point in the range or a point on the surface where the vector r in terms of u and v, the terminal point is actually on the surface. In this example, we want to identify and sketch the parametric surface S given by r of u and v. This vector valued function equals 3 cosine ui plus 3 sine uj plus vk, where u is between 0 and 2 pi and v is between 0 and 4. And what we have here is we have an equation for x, y, and z. Those are the components of the vector. We can say x is equal to 3 cosine u, y is equal to 3 sine u, and z is equal to v. And then we can eliminate those parameters u and v by taking these equations and rewriting them. Again, x is equal to 3 cosine u. That's the component, the first component. Y is equal to 3 sine u. And you can square both of those and rewrite it so that you get the equation x squared plus y squared is equal to 3 squared. So you know that's the equation of a circle in the xy plane. Now, so that's how your x and y are related. Now the z here is equal to v. And here we have v is between 0 and 4. So x and y represent the circle while v represents the z here going from 0 to 4. So what we have as a result is the circle in the xy plane, and then z is any value between 0 and 4. So what we have is a cylinder, where the height of that cylinder is 4 and the radius is 3. So the original parametric surface represented using the parameters u and v is translated to a surface in space that you can also use x, y, and z to represent that surface. Let's try this example. Find the rectangular equation by eliminating the parameters and then sketch. This vector valued function r in terms of u and v equals 2u cosine vi plus 2u sine vj plus 1/2 u squared k. Try this one on your own and then pause the video and then come back and sketch and check your work. We begin by finding the equations x is equal to 2u cosine v So this first component is what x is equal to. And then we have y is equal to 2u sine v. And z is equal to 1/2 u squared. We want to eliminate the parameters u and v so that we get an equation with x, y, and z. One way of doing that is being familiar with the trig identity that involves cosine and sine. Recall that cosine squared v plus sine squared v is going to equal 1. So let's solve for cosine v in the first equation, and we can do that by dividing both sides by 2u, and we get cosine v is equal to x divided by 2u. We want to solve for sine v. Again, we can do that by dividing both sides of this equation by 2u, and we get sine v is equal to y divided by 2u. Now we're going to make the substitution into this trig identity. We square both sides of cosine v equation. If we square this side and we square this side, we know that cosine squared v is going to be the same thing as x squared over 4u squared. Plus, we've already solved for sine v, so if we square both sides here, we know that sine squared v is equal to y squared over 4u squared equals 1. So now we've eliminated the parameter v by using this substitution. We have x and y, and we also have a u in this equation, but we want to use the following here to be able to simplify this, to eliminate that parameter u. We can multiply both sides of this equation by 4u squared, and that's going to simplify to x squared plus y squared is equal to 4u squared. Let's go ahead and solve for this equation for u squared. If we were to solve this for u, we can multiply both sides by 2, multiply by 2, and then the resulting equation is u squared equals 2z. What we'll do is replace this u squared in this equation with 2z, so we can eliminate that final parameter of u. So we get x squared plus y squared is equal to 4u squared, but I'm going to replace the u squared with 2z. So we get x squared plus y squared is equal to 8z. Now this is an equation with x, y, and z only. This is a rectangular equation. And if you refer back to the previous chapter, chapter 11 on surfaces and space, this is an elliptic paraboloid. And you can go back to using the trace method to sketch this graph. But just quickly, I do a quick sketch here. You can solve for z and do the xz and the yz trace, and notice that those are both going to be parabolas that open up. So you have a parabola that opens up in the xz plane, and a parabola that opens up in the yz plane, and the cross sections are circles. This is an elliptic paraboloid, or simply a paraboloid.